Welcome to Amoeba Sisters Short, about passive and active transport. Passive transport includes diffusion and osmosis. It doesn't require added energy, so no ATP required. Substances move with their gradient, which means a net movement from a high to low concentration. So if the high concentration of a substance is outside of the cell, the net movement of the substance will be in. If the high concentration of a substance is inside the cell, the net movement will be out. Some substances need to go through a protein to get through, facilitated diffusion, but since this goes with the gradient and doesn't require ATP, it's still passive transport. Active transport uses ATP to move substances against their gradient. For example, this cell could use active transport to help move glucose from a low concentration to high concentration, which is against the gradient. Bulk transport is also active transport. Bulk transport includes endocytosis, which can bring large particles in, and exocytosis, which can take them out.